Hello everyone, welcome to NextGen AI Academy. Hope you are doing good. In the previous video, we have learned about categorical data. The best way to find whether it's categorical data or not is by checking whether we can perform arithmetic operation or not. If we can't perform any arithmetic operation, then we can consider that data as categorical data. Then the categorical data further classified into nominal and ordinal data. Nominal data means the named or labeled data. We have seen few examples like gender, blood group, direction, jersey number. So these are all few examples where we can't do any comparison, just the name. We can't conclude like male is greater than female, east is better than north. We can't come to such conclusion, just labeled or named data. Then second type, ordinal data. Ordinal data deals with the order. For example, customer feedback, like very good, good and bad. Then economic status, low, medium, high class. Then sizes like small, medium, large. Then designation, we have a different designation. So these are all some famous examples like we can order it. And one more important point to remember about ordinal is whenever we say ordinal, it will contains the properties of nominal and then ordinal. That point keep it in mind. Now let's learn about the numerical data. As we already know, when arithmetic operation, if we can perform it, then we call that as a numerical data. Further classified into two types. So the first one is discrete and second type is continuous. Discrete means whole number. Continuous means any number with decimal points. So let's focus on discrete. So whenever we get any data set as a whole number, then we call that as a discrete. Here examples like the number of team participated, example 10 team, and total number of cars like 1200. The number of active COVID cases, some numerical numbers without any decimal point. Here one important point is we cannot divide or broke these number into individual parts or fractions or decimal. For example, when we consider COVID data set, these numbers are discrete number. All the numbers are whole number. You can't say 5.5 active case. We have to answer the number using whole number. Same way ICICI ranking, so there are some points given for each players. Those numbers also fall under whole number. These are all few real-time examples. Then the another type of numerical data is continuous data, that is the output with decimal numbers. When we talk about the continuous data, it is further classified into interval and ratio. So first nominal, second one is ordinal, and third one is interval, fourth one is ratio. Let's discuss one by one. Whenever we consider any data as interval, means the first point to remember is the interval scale contains the properties of nominal and ordinal. It means it will be a named data and we can order the data. Then what is an additional thing in interval? Here the second point comes, equal distance between the value. What that means? Tell me one thing, in the ordinal scale of measurement, is it possible to calculate the distance between these two values? that is the distance between very good and good, and the distance between good and bad. Is it possible to calculate the distance? It's not possible. We can tell very good is better than good, but we can't conclude very good is twice as good as bad. Like large is twice as good as small. CEO is twice better than manager. We can't tell that, only we can order it. So there is no distance. Usually in the data science project, we will convert these values to number, like very good for 1, good for 2, and bad for 3. Like this we will convert it, then only we will manipulate it. But then also the distance is not possible to calculate. So that is one important point in the ordinal scale. Ordinal scale we can compare it, but we can't calculate the difference between two values. Okay, let me explain with you an example for interval scale data. Let's consider the temperature in degree Celsius. So you have 15 degree, then 30, then 45, then 60 degree. So everything I will say this as in degree Celsius. So what is the distance between, or interval between, or difference between these two values? It is 15, 15, 15. So every value is equal interval. Even if you mention 15, 16, 17, the interval between these two values are equal. So based on that, let's consider this example. So here the interval is equal. That's what mentioned here, equal distance between the value, and then we can perform only addition and subtraction. The differences is allowed. Then the fourth point is zero is arbitrary. This is very important point. With this only we can differentiate between interval and a ratio. It means the ratio of the values have no meaning. Here they mentioned addition and subtraction only possible. Let's try to do the division. 60 by 32. What this mean? 60 degree Celsius is twice hot as 30 degree Celsius. Is it possible to conclude like that by doing the ratio? Definitely it's impossible. We can't do it. Only I can say the difference between the temperature inside the home and the outside is 30 degree. I can tell, but I can't tell outside temperature is twice hot as inside temperature. That type of conclusion is not possible in the interval scale. So it means zero is an arbitrary. So zero doesn't make any sense. It is having the properties of nominal ordinal. It will have an equal distance between the value. In addition to that, only we can perform addition or subtraction. Here I showed you a simple example like difference between two value, and ratio of the values have no meaning. That's called as zero is arbitrary. So that's about the interval. Now the next one is ratio. So when we talk about ratio scale of measurement, the first point, it contains the properties of nominal, that is named, ordinal, ordered, and interval data. You know what is the properties for interval data? It will have equal distance. That's about the interval data, and there is no absolute zero. So these three properties, in addition to that, the ratio of two values are meaningful. This is important point. Here the ratio in the interval doesn't have any meaningful, but in the ratio data scale we will have a meaningful. Here we can perform addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, and it is a true zero. Let me explain you with an example. Here I have mentioned height, weight and marks. Let's see with the marks. In a class, some may get 20 marks, some may get 40 marks, some may get 60 marks, some may get 80 marks. Let's consider this scenario. So first nominal, so nominal we have name. Second one is ordinal. We have to arrange in an order when we talk about a mark. And third one is interval. It is having a equal distance between two values. And now fourth one, the ratio will give a meaningful. For example, when you divide 80 by 40 equal to 2, I can say the student who got 80 marks, I will say, is twice better than 40 marks. Am I right? This is a meaningful conclusion. So this is the only shortcut or a cheat code we will be using to differentiate between internal and the ratio. Same way, one more example. Your weight is like 40 kg, my weight is 80 kg. I can say my weight is twice your weight. So here that ratio makes a sense. Same way, twice taller than you. Here when we apply that ratio concept, it will be a meaningful one. So that's about the ratio scale. Let's summarize the types of data scale. So here the name, order, difference is measurable and true zero. When you consider first one, nominal, in the nominal only we talk about the name. We can't order it, we can't measure it, there is no true zero value. So numerical will not come into the picture of nominal. And second one, ordinal, here the name is allowed. In addition to that, we will order it, but there is no numerical properties. Then third one, interval, we have named, then ordered. In addition to that, the difference is measurable. So you can able to difference between two interval, and that is will have a equal distance. But it's not possible to have a ratio, full ratio, which is other way called true zero is not possible. Absolute zero is not possible. We can say in multiple ways. And fourth one, ratio. It is like properties of named, ordered, measurable, and also it will give a meaningful ratio. True zero exists. So that's about the measurement of scale. With this knowledge, from next video, we will try to plot the graph for different types of data. Categorical and numerical, so many combinations are there. We will try to learn that one by one. Hope you got a good clarity about this topic. That's the end of this video. Thanks for watching. Happy learning.